apply for the money. And I said, no, I haven't done that. Yeah, right.
$50 million supplemental. I introduced the fund, the officer reparations, the staffing, the committee's approved recommendations, a database to locate eligible participants.
I have no plans at this time to support that request.
And I haven't heard from him. I haven't heard from the Bay Area.
I'm Natasha Wilson. From your home for 24/7.
One of my accounts shut down.
Really? Okay. Well, you know what? When I do see you, you're gonna have peace of my mind.
Yeah. That's not something I use, but it's that Facebook shop that they've got, and I never used that thing, but still the fact he got one of my, you know, it's like, oh, no, you know what, no.
Oh, yeah, no, it's a lot of stuff on there that I kind of have got from there, just no go travel, but
see, I normally, if I'm going shopping, I normally will shop on either Amazon or I'll shop on eBay.
Yeah, no, I guess. I mean, I prefer in purse. You know, like shopping online, unless it's like an emergency.
Can drive. I can't. So when my shop, if there's no way around, then it's like, okay, you get it off of Facebook or eBay or Amazon.
Oh yeah. No, even before I go, I still want in person. See, I like the mine's just too many. Yeah, I was like trying stuff on like that. I don't know. It's, yeah.
How much I wanted to go for a pizza today, and I said, no, you're fasting today, so you're not having any of that stuff.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Alright, I'll
bring
it back.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, boy. Here we go again with the door, Sam. This bitch bitch needs to stop slamming the doors.
The Bay Area's BIN 910 and on the iHeartRadio app.
I'm gonna fucking knock her out.
I'm Bill Black with another bet you didn't know music back. All right, class, today let's talk about the song that got away. So this is your dish. You know, Ronnie Bobby, Ricky Mike, Johnny Ralph. And they've given us hits throughout the years like If It Didn't Love, Candy Girl, and Can You Stand the Rain? The song that was written with New Edition in mind, but kind of got away. Let me explain. Let's take it back to 1985 and the movie Crush Groove, starring Blair Underwood, Sheila E., and a slew of rappers like LL Cool J, Run DMC, The Fat Boys, and even New Edition was in the movie. Producers Jimmy Jam and Terry Lewis were asked to write a ballad for the love scene in the movie. But due to contract negotiations, New Edition's label would not allow them to record the song for the soundtrack. The song instead went to the Foursome Beats. The song, Tender Love. I'm Bill Black with another Bet You Didn't Know Music Fact on the Black Information Network.
Got a story or just want to leave us some feedback? Call the Black Information Network hotline at 855-500-9BIN. The opinions, beliefs, and viewpoints expressed in this commentary are those of the author and do not necessarily represent those of BIN and its founding partners and employees.
I'm Mo Kelly on BIN with your 2-minute warning. Cool in the Gang is coming up on its 60th anniversary. The group has a new album, People Just Want to Have Fun, and is presently touring the country. I spoke to Robert Cool Bell, bassist and founding member, asking him what songs they have to perform while touring. Listen to what he had to say. On your set list, what are the songs that you know you're going to have to play before you get up out of there of the Hollywood Bowl? What three songs do you have to play other than Celebration and Ladies Night?
Oh, I have to have a little bit more. We gotta play Fuck Yourself.
We can't get up.
certainly Hollywood swinging.
Bitch coming. Fucking racist. Bitch. That's good.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, by this time of the month, I want to put more money in there. Just make sure I've got plenty of money for the rest of the month.
Oh, yeah.
Not much, but I did pretty good, but I just have to tell myself, you can't spend that. You can't. You have to hang on to that. But I want to spend it. No, you can't.
Here. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. You're already signed out and that kind of thing, so you're fine.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going in and get
ready.
All right.
Oh, yeah. No.
Tell Kevin I said hello.
Oh, yeah. No. Oh, yeah.
And
sure.
Don't forget to give him the keys.
No, I'm not forgetful. Okay, shut the fuck up. Bitch. Yeah, you shut the fuck up and everything will be okay.
Herbal is finding himself in trouble with the law again. According to TMZ, the rapper was arrested over the weekend in Chicago, Illinois, and charged for unlawful use of a weapon in a public place. He's since been bonded out of jail, but will have to return to court at a later date. This isn't the first legal setback G Herbal has faced. In 2020, he and his crew were charged in a fraud scheme involving designer puppies and private jets. Elsewhere, congratulations are in order for actress Issa Rae. Variety reports that Radio, which is a part of her Hooray Media company, has inked a multi-year deal with Def Jam Recording. This partnership will reportedly allow Radio to sign, market, and distribute signed musicians throughout Def Jam's network. Very cool. The president of the company, Benoni Tago, says in part, quote, together we look forward to expanding our reach and fostering a creative home for our new artists. And Janet Jackson is further proving why she is the legend that she is. According to the Daily Mail, Jenna has broken her own box office record, surpassing all of her previous touring records during her 40-year career. She's earned a whopping $51 million on her current Together Again tour, with 479,000 tickets sold. The multi-award-winning icon's ticket sales make this her 10th tour, her biggest grossing tour to date. Both of her shows in New York and Madison Square Garden were a big part of getting her over the mark, as she reportedly sold 24,500 tickets and grossed $3.8 million from those shows alone. With the latest in entertainment at 17 and 47 minutes past each hour, I'm Bree Wood on your home for 24/7 News, the Black Information Network, and BINnews.com.
I'm Devin Dunstan on the Black Information Network. In 1966, an African-American nurse by the name of Mary Van Britten Brown was concerned about the high crime rate in her New York City neighborhood. Her husband was away from home a lot, and she felt that she needed more protection than a simple door lock offered. With the idea of beefing up security in her Queens home, Mary Van Britten Brown and her husband started working on an idea that has now become the basis of many of today's home security systems. The Browns' electronic security system was based on a camera that allowed people inside to see anyone who came to the door without opening that door. Mary Brown then added a microphone, a button to unlock the door, and the ability to automatically call police if she needed help. In 1969, Mary Van Britten Brown and her husband were awarded a patent on their home security system. And today, the use of cameras, microphones, and automatic dialers are fundamental components of many security systems. It's an invention patented by an African-American nurse more than 50 years ago. And that's back. I'm Devin Dunstan on the Black Information Network.
Original Black Reporting.
The Black Information Network. Bay Area, BIN 910. I'm Doug Davis.
And I'm Amber Payton, in for Esther Dillard on your home for 24/7 News, the Black Information Network.
Here are your top stories. Officials are not letting a Michigan cop get away with violating the rights of a black man. Some black residents at a Georgia apartment complex are angry because their water was cut off after paying their bill. And
ban the assault weapons and high capacity magazines. Extensive background check. They're part of the answer. They'll make a big difference.
A new poll shows President Biden pulling ahead of Donald Trump in a hypothetical 2024 matchup. The Morning Consult poll shows 43% of registered voters would support the sitting president in the general election, compared to 42% who said that back former President Trump, he remains the clear front runner in the race for the Republican nomination.
Advocacy groups are calling for a federal investigation into New Jersey State Police internal practices. New Jersey's NAACP Director Richard Smith says the department has a long-standing history of internal bias, which has resulted in 17 discrimination lawsuits based on race, gender, and sexual orientation.
We will continue to advocate for the rights and demand that the state police take concrete steps to address discrimination and foster a culture of inclusivity.
Burnham and Douglas Law has joined calls for the Department of Justice to investigate the allegations, as well as how the agency makes promotions.
Christine King Ferris will lie in state at the Georgia Capitol on the 14th of this month. The eldest sibling of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. will be honored in the Capitol Rotunda all afternoon as people pay their respects for the former teacher and civil rights activist.
He was just such a strong, powerful, full of faith person. Like I said, dealt with lies. And I was just amazed at her ability to be able to go through all of the tragedies she went through and still stand strong.
That's the niece of Christine, Bernice King, speaking at a news conference following her aunt's death. Ferris died on June 29th at the age of 95.
The ancestors of enslaved Africans have very little to draw from when it comes to a written account of their family tree.
But now, thanks to a new study conducted by USC and Stanford University researchers, there are some written records starting from the late 1500s, but not many. Most black Americans who have some recollection of the past learn their genealogy from oral history. The researchers found that African Americans born between 1960 and 1965 can often outline their family tree, but not so much from a historical written record. You can learn more from academic.oup.com. I'm Mike Stevens on the Black Information Network.
And finally, an African-American former convict is sharing her life experience with other former women inmates in hopes of changing their lives for the better. Susan Burton had a pretty tough life, and after she lost her child, she turned to drugs and alcohol, which led to acts of crime and many stints in prison. But eventually, she went through rehabilitation and started a nonprofit called A New Way of Life, aimed to help other former women inmates find success despite the odds. I'm Doug Davis, along with Amber Payton, and for Esther Dillard on your home for 24/7 News. the Black Information Network. 100,000 BIN listeners were able to advance their careers or succeed in a new one. It would be one step towards building a better future for all of us. To learn more about the 100,000 Careers Initiative, visit careerfilter.com/BIN.
Our news, wherever you are. Tell your smart device to play the Black Information Network station on iHeartRadio.
Device to play the Black Information Network on the iHeartRadio app.
Stories you trust from people you trust.
The Black Information Network. The Bay Area's BIN 910.
Your money on the Black Information Network.
Summer gas prices have held steady nationwide. AAA's Brian Ortner says this is a welcome change from the traditional summer spike.
We're still hovering around that $70 per barrel range, a little bit above it as the week begins. You know, but we looked at the last week, even with the high demand, pump prices barely budged, really, over the past week, and that's even with more demand as people hit the road over the 4th of July holidays.
National average is around $3.54. That's 9 cents less than a week ago and 14 cents less than a month ago. Ortner says the prices are lower than last year despite record numbers of people hitting the road.
Exceeding or hitting record pre-pandemic numbers for on-the-road travel is something that's great to see at the start of school. I'm coming very last few weeks of vacation time.
But gas prices in Georgia are continuing to inch up. AAA reports the average price of a gallon of gas in the Peachtree State is $3.26. That's 6 cents more than this time last week. Money news at 24 and 54 past each hour. I'm Natasha Williams on your home for 24/7 news, the Black Information Network and BINnews.com.
Honest, credible, trusted.
The Black Information Network. The Bay Area's BIN 910.
I'm Amber Payton in for Esther Dillard.
And I'm Doug Davis on your home for 24/7 News, the Black Information Network.
Alabama lawmakers are looking at drafts of proposed congressional maps. According to WSFA, as many as 100 proposals were submitted to the state by the deadline. The U.S. Supreme Court ordered new district lines be drawn after Alabama's congressional map was considered unconstitutional due to a lack of majority black districts. Black Alabama Congresswoman Terry Sewell shared her take when the Supreme Court decision was announced.
The fact that the Supreme Court, really ruled in favor of protecting the voices of minority voters is something to be celebrated in this great democracy.
Sewell says the new districts could be expected soon.
But I would suspect that we would definitely be running in 2024 with the redrawn districts.
A final version of the new district lines must be submitted by July 21st.
Black students say they want to teach, but they never quite make it to the classroom. Research shows black students are less likely to be suspended and more likely to end up in gifted classes with a black teacher. Researchers say high tuition costs and low teacher certification completion rates could be the culprit. NAACP Board of Directors member and veteran union leader Claude Cummings Jr. is now the first black president of the Communications Workers of America. Before becoming president, Cummings had been the union vice president leading CWA's District 6 and president of Houston-based Local 6222.
Over 40 black students will receive scholarships from the Black Community Fund. In total, they'll be awarded $176,000. Each recipient will receive either $1,000 or $5,000 scholarship and must commit to 16 hours of community service.
And for more on these stories and international, national, state, and local news affecting the black community, listen to the Black Information Network on the iHeartRadio app or log on to BINnews.com. On social media, stay connected with the BIN on Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok at Black Information Network, and catch us on Twitter at Black Info Net.
I'm Amber Payton along with Doug Davis.
I want to do a large fry in 2 apple pies.
What else?
I'll do a Coke as well.
Coke?
Uh-huh. And that's it.
Some food.
Thank you. Meme, okay. That's fine. Kind of.
Science.
Yeah,
Just before the summit began, Turkey lifted its blockade on Sweden's entry into the military alliance, strengthening NATO as Russia's war against Ukraine continues to drag on. Sweden and Finland were prompted to join the alliance following Russia's invasion, and Finland was granted membership back in April. That's your Washington Roundup. I'm Morgan Wood in Washington, D.C. on your home for 24/7 News, the Black Information Network, and BINNews.com.
Okay. Oh, yeah. Thank you.
Oops.
Oh, sure. Yeah. Oh, yeah.
That's what you said you are now.
Oh, yes. Okay. There you go. Thank you. Oh, wallet outside. There we go. Hey, put this in the shirt. Kind of. That's good. Oh, there you go. Oh, man. Oof.
An officer got a tip. The 17-year-old might be armed and found a gun in his waistband yesterday. It all went down on the first day of classes at Central High. And celebrity birthdays today, rapper Lil' Kim is 49. Also, boxer Leon Spinks was born on this day in 1953. He won a gold medal at the 1976 Olympics and became the heavyweight boxing champion when he beat an aged and out-of-shape Muhammad Ali in a 15-round decision in Las Vegas in 1978. And that's the latest. I'm Doug Davis from the Black Information Network at BINNews.com.
I'm Vanessa Tyler.
And I'm Mike Stevens on your home for 24/7 News, the Black Information Network.
This is not the news we wanted to hear.
The end of the search has come with the recovery of the body of a young child.
The district attorney relaying the tragedy. It is likely Anna, the little 7-year-old black autistic girl nearly everyone in Lowell, Massachusetts was looking for Sunday. The nonverbal child was found in the Merrimack River in Tewksbury.
It brings tears to your eyes, knowing that a child is gone after all the rescue and search and the police and reporters and everybody out there looking for this child.
Police say there were no apparent signs of foul play.
They will not take no.
We would accept the first no. We'd be attending segregated schools right now.
For the lawyers fighting for reparations for the historical damage done in the 1921 Tulsa race massacre, the judge's ruling against them is not the final word. They will appeal.
I think I speak for my team when I say, in echo, that this is not over. And this will not be over until we get justice for our survivors. Justice for
the
defendants and justice for Greenwood.
The judge dismissed the lawsuit by the survivors and the sentence, the lawyers say. The judge did not give a reason why. The two survivors who lived through that race massacre and sat through this trial are more than 100 years old.
But the burning down of the Greenwood District in Tulsa and the massacre of hundreds of black people by racist whites should not be tied to skin color, not to mention race. Is a stunning statement from Oklahoma white school superintendent Ryan Walters. The far-right educator speaking at a public hearing says lessons about the infamous massacre do not have to mention race. Walters also has come under fire for his restrictions on critical race theory, among his other controversial decisions.
Police wear body cams, why not doctors? So we can see how black patients are treated. That suggestion from a Yale psychiatrist
doctor writing in an opinion piece in the Boston Globe.